So here in this, what we have to learn or what we have to see today, the earth and its living world. I want the answers for these questions. So when I'll ask you, you have to answer. Okay. So your first question is, where do you get water from? Where do you get water from? Come on, answer.
We get water from rain.
Rain. Anything else?
Oceans.
Yes, Sumedh gave na answer. Okay. Anyone else? Oceans and
sea.
Sea. Valleys. Valleys.
Valleys.
Teacher, river.
We get water from
river.
River. Ocean. Okay. Reservoir. Okay, we have to see that. Where do you get water from? So you got gave the answer to me. Now again, there's one more question for you. So where do you get water from? We get water from rain, lakes, river, sea, ocean, reservoir, and many more, etc. Now next. Where do we lay the foundation of a building? Where do we lay the foundation of a building? Give me the answer. Where do you lay the foundation of a building? What can you see here? What is this down?
It's your land.
Land, very good. On the land, on the surface of the earth. We lay the foundation of the building on the surface of the earth. But what do you mean by foundation, boys? What do you mean by foundation?
Base.
The base. Very good. See, when you come to school, when you get take admission, you directly don't go to fifth standard. First, you complete your pre-primary. Why? Because you should know the basics. That is A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4, your spellings, your tables. And then you go ahead standard-wise. Then you come to the secondary. So what is this? Here, you have started with your pre-primary. Means what? Your base is your nursery, senior KG, junior KG. All these are your base. That is your strong foundation. And when your foundation is strong, that means when your basics are clear, then you know you will progress and you will get good marks. Similarly, here also, whenever you want to construct any building, straight away you don't start with the constructing the walls and the building will stand. No, it's not so. It's not so. If there is no foundation on the surface of the earth, it is little bit of digging and then they lay the foundation. If that foundation is not there and if you construct a building straight away, it will fall down. The way you have a foundation of your school, of your learning, similarly, there should be a foundation for constructing also. So the houses which are constructed, the buildings which are constructed will always have a foundation. So whenever earthquakes are there or any other calamities are there, if there is no foundation, it will fall down. So for that, to lay the foundation, you need the surface of the earth. So that was your answer. Let's go ahead again.
Teacher, your network is...
So where do you lay the foundation of the building? On the land or surface of the earth.
Nahi teacher ko malum rahe.
Some child is talking and see that it's muted. Yeah. What need do we meet from the breathing? When you breathe, what is the need you meet? See here in this picture, you can see you inhale air. Inhale means you breathe in. You breathe in and you breathe out. This is breathing. Inhalation and exhalation together is breathing. what need do we meet through the breathing? What you get through breathing? Why? What is there? What your body needs when you breathe?
Oxygen.
Very good. The answer is we get oxygen.
Oxygen.
Next question is, from where does the earth gets light and heat? Your answer you can see on the screen itself.
The earth gets light from the sun.
Very good. Now mute yourself. Mute. All of you mute. Okay. So, again, I'll go on the screen. The earth gets light and heat from the sun. So here you can see the sun. Sun, the energy which we get from the sun is the solar energy. And this solar energy is used by all the living things on the earth. It may be human beings, it may be plants, or it may be animals. So all the living things which are there on living on the surface of the earth, living on the earth, it gets light and heat from the sun. Now, as we are living on the earth, so we have land also and even water also on the earth. Land and water both are available on the earth. So here you can see the land and water both are available on the earth, but the proportion of water is more as compared to land. On the surface of the earth, we find land in some places and water in some places. Moving on to this slide, see here, this picture is about air, atmosphere. You can see the layer of air which is spread around the earth. This is our earth, and this is the diminished, it's not so much visible here. You can see the layer of air. So the earth is surrounded by the layer of air, and it is known as atmosphere. So our earth is surrounded by atmosphere. Now you can see here, as I told you, there are living things which live on the earth. But where are these living things living on? They are living on land. Example, human beings, animals are living on land. There are living things living in water also. Example, fish and other marine animals. And there are living things which are in the air. Example, birds. Okay, so the living things are on land, in water, and in air. Here, the sun is the cause of many natural processes on the earth. What do you mean by that? The sun is the cause of many natural processes. What are natural processes? Example, the plants prepare their own food. It's a natural process. And the plants need sunlight to prepare their food. Similarly, to maintain the ecological balance, there are different food chain on the earth. It is only because of the sun's energy. Sun's light and heat, all the living things want. Because if the living things will not get the solar energy, the things will die. Human beings also need the solar energy. And we have different equipments which are made because of the solar energy. You know, solar cooker, solar water heater, solar geysers, solar bulbs. So here, all the natural processes which are there on the earth, it needs the sun's energy. Now let us see, this is your surface of the earth. So on the surface of the earth, which are the layers? There are different layers on the surface of the earth. So here, the layer of water, the layer of water is called hydrosphere. The layer of water is called hydrosphere. Hydro means water. Sphere means layer. Layer. Again, I'll repeat. Hydro means water. Sphere means layer. So, layer of water is called hydrosphere. Layer of land on the earth is called lithosphere. Lithos means land. Sphere means, again, layer. So, lithos, land. Sphere, layer. Layer of land is called lithosphere. Moving ahead, layer of air is called atmosphere. Atmos means air. Sphere means layer. So, the layer of air is called atmosphere. So, which are the three layers on the earth? Hydrosphere, lithosphere, atmosphere. Layer of water, hydrosphere. Layer of land, lithosphere. And layer of air, atmosphere. Together, the layer of hydrosphere, this hydrosphere, lithosphere, and atmosphere, together, the combination of these three is your biosphere. Biosphere spreads in all the three spheres. The biosphere spreads in all the three spheres, hydrosphere, lithosphere, and atmosphere. See, check this slide here. Biosphere spreads in all other three spheres. Example, this is land, lithosphere, water, hydrosphere, and atmosphere layer. So, all the combination of these three is biosphere. So, biosphere spreads in all the three spheres. This picture is in your book, in your textbook. We are living over here. We live here on the land, layer of land, that is lithosphere. We are on the lithosphere. Layer of water here, you can see here, hydrosphere, that means it's water. And atmosphere, you can see the birds flying and the clouds. This is the layer of air, atmosphere. So, the combination of atmosphere, hydrosphere, and lithosphere is your biosphere. These are the spheres of the earth. Now, look at this picture. The earth's crust, the surface of the earth is known as earth's crust. So, this earth's crust is not liquid. It is very hard. Why it is hard? Because it is made up of rocks. So, your earth's crust or surface of the earth is made up of rock particles. It is made up of rocks. Now, as I told you, there is land on the surface of the earth and there is water also. But what is the proportion of land and water? Here, the proportion of water is 2/3. And the proportion of land is 1/3. Again, I'll repeat. The proportion of water on the earth is 2/3, or it is 71%. And the proportion of land is 1/3, or 29%. Remember these two proportions, land and water. So, water is more than land on the earth. Now, this land which is there on the earth is divided into different continents. We will move ahead and let's see that the continents. Now, look here. How is the land? Land is not even everywhere. I told you about different landforms. When I explained you the lesson, maps are companions, I explained you the different landforms. Okay, boys, you have to unmute and answer my questions. Which are the different landforms? Different landforms. I told you the landforms in the previous lesson. Yes, Rudra is raising the hand. Yes, Rudra.
Mountains.
Mountains.
Valley.
Yes.
Hills.
Yes. Plateaus.
Islands.
Rivers.
Islands and plateaus.
Rivers. Very good.
Teacher, rivers, oceans.
Teacher, river and oceans. So these are the different landforms. So let us see more. There's a picture in your textbook, so that I have put here related to this. So see here. Here you can see it's a hilly area. Now this hilly region, we can see layer of soil and rocks. You can see the rocks here, pebbles and rocks here. And the layer of soil also. Here you can see the soil and the rocks, layer of rocks. Okay, so here, the hilly region, we can see the layer of soil and rock particles. I muted you all, still there is noise. Again,
is there more given for
next? Is see this picture, see the slide. We see grassy expanses of land in some places, that means you can see grass. See, in the previous slide, we saw rock particles. Here you can see the grass which is there, extension, you can see overall. So this land, in some places the land is grassy, in some places the land is covered with crops. These are the crops which are there. So you can say the land varies. Somewhere it is a rocky land, somewhere it is covered with crops, somewhere it is covered with grass, and in some places it is covered with forests. You can see the tall trees over here in the forest area, this one. So this is some, the land is covered with the forest area. Now here, this is a tree, a huge tree, and these roots which are there, you can see the roots, how they are spread out. But these roots, they go deep inside the soil. Similarly, when these roots go deep inside the soil, sometimes this tree is grown in the rocks also. So what happens to the rock particles or to the big huge rock? When this tree roots, they go deep inside this rock, it breaks the rock, you get the crack. So the roots go deep into the soil. Into the soil, soil means your mud, not only mud, but other minerals, rock particles also. So the roots go deep into the soil and they spread all over. You can see the roots which are spreading all over, and it may cause a crack in the rocks also. And I asked you just now the different landforms which are a part. But these landforms which are a part, they are a part of a land, that is lithosphere. The landforms are a part of Earth's lithosphere. So you can see here, the Earth's lithosphere. Here, which are the landforms? Some of you gave the names, mountains, then hill, this we saw river, island, we saw the plateau, we saw valley, but there are other landforms also on the lithosphere. Seashore, we have the valleys, we have the hillocks. Okay, these are the different landforms which are there of the Earth's lithosphere. Now check this out. As I told you, 29% of the Earth is land. that is one third. But this land is divided into, this is a land. It is a vast land, continuous stretch of land. This land, this continuous stretch of land is divided into continents. So you should know what is a continent. The continent is a vast area of land, or we can say a proper definition. The vast continuous stretch of land is called a continent. So we have to check today the different continents. There are names given to the continents, but let us see, let's count at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Total 7 continents are there on the earth. Continents are nothing but your land, stretched land. The vast continuous stretch of land is called a continent. And there are total 7 continents. Here you can see this number is changing. Boys, this is animated. That's why this number will change here. But total 7 continents are there. Let us see one by one. This is North America, the green color. North America, South America, Europe, Asia, Africa, Australia, and Antarctica. This one. The dark green, North America. Light green, South America. North and South America. Then we have Africa. This is Africa. This is Europe, Asia, Australia, and Antarctica. Boys, the largest continent, you can see area wise also, the largest continent is Asia. Asia is the largest continent, and this is our country India. See here, India, our country India is in the continent of Asia. This is Asia, and our country is in the Asia continent. So the largest continent is Asia, and the smallest continent is Australia. The smallest is Australia. You can actually see here on, according to area, the smallest is Australia. And every time you can see here, Eurasia, Eurasia. What do you mean by Eurasia? It's Europe and Asia. Is Eurasia. Why it is Eurasia? Look at this picture. These two continents, there are water bodies here. They are separated because of the strait. Here also Africa and Europe, there are water bodies. This white color is water body. Here also there are water bodies. So this continent is separated. Here there are no water bodies. Europe and Asia, there is no single water body. You can see the land is joined. Adjoining land is joined. That's why it is known as Eurasia. Both are connected with land, not connected with water body. So the largest continent is Asia and the smallest continent is Australia. So these are the 7 continents. This is a newly discovered continent, Antarctica, and there is no life over there. There are no, the people don't stay there. I hope you understood this. The part, just a minute. Yes, you can unmute.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher. Yes, teacher.
Okay, now listen. Now listen. Lesson is lengthy. This lesson is lengthy. So I have divided this lesson into. According to the topics I have divided. So we saw a part of that lesson today. So whatever part we saw today of the lesson, please read it from your textbook. Then you will understand better. Immediately read it. And after this session gets over, I will give you the online test in the form of a game. You enjoyed the quizzes. Quizzes you enjoyed.
Yes, teacher.
So today, because
yes, teacher.
I,
yes, teacher.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, teacher.
Teacher, when?
Immediately now, once the session ends, I will give you. And you know the steps, because I forwarded you the steps in the previous...
I have one doubt.
Wait a minute, let me complete my statements and then you can ask me the doubts. So, I'll forward you the link of the quizzes. So, solve the link. Do not post the marks. I don't want screenshot. I don't want any marks. It is only for you. Remember, I hope the parents are around. Okay, I don't want any marks of this. When the lesson will get over, this lesson, that time I will send you one test mode link. I want the marks of that. Today, today you will only give the test. It's an online quizzes. Go for it and evaluate yourself whatever you have understood. Okay. Now, those who have doubts, you can ask. Tell me your name. Sheila was having a doubt.
Lesson number 1 and 2, is there given notes?
I have given notes for all.
Lesson number 1 and 2 also?
Yes. Who is this child? Divyam. Okay, do one thing now.
Divyam teacher.
Divyam. Okay. I will forward you the link of my channel, YouTube channel. Okay, I have uploaded all the questions and answers over there. So those who did not have any link, go on that channel and check, search for
teacher,
the questions and answers.
Teacher, send in the group link.
I'll send the channel link.
Yes, teacher. Lesson number 1 and 2.
No problem. One more thing, boys. The Marathi chi kavita ahe, darav darav. Tyache prashna uttar mi tithe dile ahe. Te pan bagu shakta. Ani kal mi ek post kele, Nachre Mora, explanation of Nachre Mora. That also you can go and see on my YouTube channel. Okay?
Yes,
keep this link with yes, you of my YouTube channel. You will get the updates over there.
Teacher, send the link of lesson 1 and 2.
I will not send
teacher,
the link.
Send the link of lesson 1 and 2.
Search on my channel. I am sending the link of my channel. I have uploaded everything there. Clear? Okay, boys?
Yes, teacher.